I have crossed the horizon to find you. I know your name. They have stolen the heart from inside you. But this does not define you. This is not who you are. You know who you are.
Hey, y'all. Welcome back to my channel, y'all. Last weekend, my mom decided to watch Moana for the first time, and I have not seen that movie in a while. And that scene, that song that I just showed you was towards the end. And if you couldn't really hear the lyrics say, it's a song called Do You Know Who You Are? Or Know Who You Are from the Disney movie Moana. And the lyrics say, I have crossed the horizon to find you. I know your name. They have stolen the heart from inside you, but this does not define you. This is not who you are. You know who you are. And that really, really, really touched my heart. Like, I don't know if it was just so because of all that's been going on recently in my life. And just, it just brought me back to just knowing who I am and coming a long way and figuring out who I was from all the things that I have experienced in the past, all the things that I had to go through, and how it's really built me and my character to be stronger, to be wiser, to be better and greater than I was before, and just not allowing experiences in my life to dim my light, as I said before and even in the last video, and just realizing that I am where I am today because of God and His grace, and I am where I am today because God knew me and the plans He had for me and the plans He has for us before we were born. And it's all led up to me living this like sold out life for Him, and just living kingdom and striving to be better, as a person, as a Christian woman, as a young adult, just striving to be better. And that movie, if you haven't seen Moana, I really suggest that you watch it. There's so many different themes that you can take away from the movie, but that song really resonated with me just because of that scene where she's been searching, she's been looking for this particular she was on a particular journey to go somewhere, and she wanted to, like, it's a stone that she wanted to give back to, I can't think of the name at the moment, Tahiti or something like that, and to place it back in them so that, you know, she can take care of her family, so that this, like, dark cloud that's been hovering over her island and her family, that's like, and she basically was the one to do it. She was the one chosen for the mission. She was the one handpicked to carry it out and basically change the world. And when I think about this scene and when I think about the movie, I'm just reminded, like she said, of do you know who you are? Do you know who you are? And it reminded me of God and just our names and how our names really do mean something. And I searched the definition for Moana, and her name means ocean, sea. Wide expanse of water. And in the movie, she loved from just a child, she loved going into water. She, like, her and the water were just like one. And the water helped guide her through the journey and, you know, made sure she got it and took care of her. And so then I remember I looked up my name to remember what it was, because I used to have this little card that broke down the definition of my name and where it originated from and everything like that. So my name, Audrey, means noble strength. And so then I broke it down even further. And I looked up the definition for noble, which means having traits or showing traits that people admire. Traits as far as like generosity, courage, and honesty. And I can say a lot of people have told me time and time again how they do admire me, how my personality and my courageousness and my boldness, not only just for God or for to step out in faith, but just the things that I've had to endure in my life and how I've overcame them with such class and such courage and bravery and strength. And then for the other part of my name, strength, which means to be able to withstand great pressure or being physically strong. And I truly believe that that is something that that I've had to endure. And I don't know, I remember my mama telling me the other day that, well, and I also knew this, but she, I forget what we were watching, but there was a guy on there whose name was Sydney, and she was like, that could have been your name. But I was like, I like my name. Like, I don't look like a Sydney. I feel like, I think she chose that name, Audrey. She chose the name Audrey not knowing, you know, what her daughter would have to endure, in her life, but it fits. It's perfect. Like I said, I've had to overcome so much, recently, but I made it. And I go and I tell people my name, or people ask me my name, and they're like, oh my gosh, I love that name. That name is so pretty. You know, that name is coming back. That name was so old, but it's coming back now. I just love that name. I've had so many people tell me that. And I just really, really, really love the fact that we just think, you know, we just want to name a child, or people think that they just want to name a child just because, you know, it's cute and they make it up. But I feel like, this is my personal opinion, I feel like God gives you the names for a reason, and because he specifically designed and created us before our parents even knew we were coming, and they just fit and they just stick. And that, again, that movie, Moana, just about her strength and her journey and how she knew from a child, like, what it was that God put in her, basically, and what it was that God created her in this earth to fix, the problem that she had to fix, and the strength that she had, and the training that she had to go through, and the journey that she had to go through. And even times like with us in real life, you know, we know we have this passion and we have this desire to do so much, but it seems impossible sometimes. And it's just like, Lord, why is this on my mind? Like, why is this, like, so strong in my heart? Why is this what I want to do? Like, and it won't go away. I can't shake it. And people are, they're either pushing me to do it, but like, her father was like trying so hard to block her and wouldn't listen to her. And we have people like that in real life who don't understand who they are, or maybe lost it along the way as her father did. He lost it because of a tragedy that he experienced, so it turned his heart cold and just blocked out everything. He put up a wall and he never wanted to, you know, have anything to do with the situation any longer. But the light that Moana had is similar to the light that God places in us to be a world changer, as I said before, to make a difference in this world. Because again, we've all were created on purpose, for a purpose, to fix a problem in this earth. And And though, you know, some people may try to shatter those dreams, sometimes people may try to talk you out of them because they don't feel like, you know, well, they couldn't do it, so why should you be able to do it? But I'm sitting here and I'm telling you and encouraging you, as I always say, encouraging myself to continue to pursue what you feel like God has placed in your heart, because there is a reason that you are still here, that you are still in the land of the living, that you're still breathing, that there's a reason that the situations that could have taken you out have not, no matter if people understand it, no matter if people agree with it, no matter if people support you, no matter if people try their hardest to get you to do something else because they feel like this is what you should do because it didn't work for them, or it's a silly dream, or you're not gonna make no money out of it, or it's not gonna, you know, bring you any, you know, wealth or whatever. I'm telling you right now today that it don't matter what they say. If you know that God has placed something in your heart and in your soul to do it, do it. And I tell you from experience, just like in my last video, what I told you that not my last video, but it was a video before that, and I was telling you, like, I'm really living in answer prayers right now. And the things that I had, I didn't understand it then, but the things that I had to experience, the weight that I had to endure, WEIGHT, also WAIT, was all a part of God's plan, and it was necessary. And it makes a difference because, like I've said, it makes a difference because if he gives it to you too fast, you won't be able to handle it. You won't be in the right mindset for it. So even though it may seem like it's taking forever to happen, or it's taking forever to jump off, or you may even be like feeling like you're not prepared for it, I encourage you all to pray. I encourage you all to fast. I encourage you all to spend time in devotion and make room for God so that he can help you to learn the lessons that you need to learn and understand the things that you need to understand so that you can get to where he has what he has for you, what he has for you, the blessings, the plans, and all that, because it's all for good, right? And this movie just touched my spirit, y'all. Like, I was just like, oh my God, I love this movie. Like, it is so encouraging. Like, you cannot allow people to stop you. You cannot allow how people feel about certain things to stop you or to dim your light. Because like I said, in the last video, in Matthew 5 and 16, it says to let your light shine out for all to see so that everyone will praise your heavenly Father. And even though Moana's daddy was mad and angry, you know, he was upset, didn't want her to, you know, he wanted to put his foot down, and he didn't want her to go out there and do it. But her grandmama, she knew. She was like, you are the chosen one. Like, you are the one to do this. You are the one to save this island, to save our family for generations upon generations. And she's a world changer. And she didn't understand it because she started, you know, she was so hype about it. She was like, I got it, I got it. But then again, when people try to come and snatch the light out of you, or dim your light, or take, you know, just try to help, just try to block you from living your dream and doing what you know you have been sent on this earth to do, she got discouraged, and she was like, I can't do it, why me? Even through the journey, you know, there was experiences and things along the way that was trying to block her, that was trying to stop her, but she kept going. Even, you know, there were little coconut things that was trying to attack her and Maui on the boat. There was storms. There was so many things. Even Maui, who was with her, didn't believe it or didn't care, didn't want to. But she even and it she even changed his mind about it because of her spirit and her and her like desire to keep going and to keep pushing. She allowed her light to even shine in somebody else's light and make a difference and change his mind. And that's also what God wants for us to do. He wants us to let our light shine for all the world to see, to conform to his character, to treat everybody with kindness and love, no matter what they did, no matter what they've done, because he was the reason that her island was basically, you know, slowly but surely being destroyed, because he's the one that stole the heart out of Tahiti and had it. And she was like, and she sat there, and her grandmother, I remember her grandmother told her, you know, your name is Moana. And she gave her this speech, like, and when you see him, you tell him this, 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 and that. And she did it, and it made a difference, and they became friends. He looked out for her. He helped her along the way. He was able to change. She was able, like I said, she was able to let her light shine, to be standing what she believed in. And for us, we will stand in what we believe in and stand in our faith and let our light shine so that we can change the world and change those around us in our everyday life and lead them to Christ too. And that's what I believe that God has placed on my heart. Like I said before, I didn't know what it was that God wanted me to do for so long. Like it was like, do I go do nursing? Do I work in a hospital? But I love kids. I'm burnt out on this. I don't know what to do. But I knew that I was there for a particular reason, for in the hospital for as long as I was, because of the people that were coming through, the coworkers that I had, and you know, the patients that I seen, their family members that I had. And I knew that I was there for a reason, because people, they are attracted to me because of how I carry myself, because of the experiences that they know that I go through, and I had to even endure some of the same things that they had to do, that were patients on that specific floor. And by how I handle it, by how I made a way through it, how God made a way through it for me, I was able to be a witness and a testimony to the people that were going through some of the same things as I was, as far as breast cancer or any other type of cancer. And people kept telling me, like, well, why don't you go and work here because you make this amount of money? Or why don't you go and do this because you'll make this amount of money? But I remember us, like, God wasn't telling me to leave, even though I was, like, it could be so frustrating, even though it could be so tiring and physically on the body. If I would have listened to those people, who knows where I would have been today. I could have been trying to just jump into an opportunity just because the money looked right, but I'd be miserable. I could have been hired and fired within a week or two and then been left with nothing. You know what I mean? So it's just like, it's again, just to reiterate my point, like, you cannot allow people to try to talk you out of things that you know that God is telling you to do. You cannot allow people, just because they would do it, don't mean that you have to. And if you think about it, when just because it's an opportunity doesn't mean it's always a God opportunity, doesn't mean it's always something that you're supposed to do, even if it's in your field. You could be, like I said, you could be hired and fired just like that. Things can happen and you jumping into opportunity just because the money looks good or the opportunity seems good doesn't mean there's always something. So that's why I encourage people all the time, as I do too, to allow God into your space and acknowledge him in all that you do, and pray for him to show you the opportunities. Pray for him to show you the people that are God sent, because opportunities can be counterfeit as well. Opportunities may seem good on the outside, but when you get into it, it'd be all bad. And we don't know that. I don't want that, and I know y'all don't want that either. But again, just remembering who you are, y'all. Remember who y'all are. Don't allow people to try to talk you out of it. Don't allow people to try to tell you about yourself. Only you and God know who you are. And God is gonna, and God knows you better than you know yourself. So he's going to allow you over and over to be able to experience your greatness, to show you the greatness that you have inside of you. You don't have to be afraid. You don't have to be stuck or feel like you're stuck, because that's not anything that God wants. He doesn't want you to be confused, because he's not the author of confusion. He don't want you to feel stuck. He doesn't want you to be down and out in despair. He wants you to live and live life abundantly. He wants you to shine. He wants his children to be lights and to be difference makers and to be world changers and to help and to serve and encourage and do it all in to glorify him as well. Just as Moana did. She wanted to do it at first. People kept trying to tear her down, but she did it anyway, and she got the mission completed. And She literally, with the little stone, she brought the light. She brought she took away the dark and shined the light, and everything worked out in her favor in the end. Everything worked out for her good and for her family's good and for the island's good in the end. Everything was restored back to health. Everything was restored back to the way that God originally created it to do. The beautiful trees, the beautiful blue water, the beautiful flowers, the smiles on everyone's faces. That's the way that God wants us to do in the earth. He wants to be able to restore health and hope and love and peace and joy back into you when you give time for him and allow him to detox you of all the things that are not like him in you, and help you to see who you are, help you to be able to be confident in who you are through him, and then you will be able to experience that light. You'll be able to see life in a different view. You won't see the darkness anymore. You'll be able to shine and just give off rays of light to other people, so they be able to shine, and then they'll be able to give off rays to other people. It's like a domino effect. Just keep going and keep going and keep going, and then and once we get there, you'll see the new that will be in this earth, the new that will be in your family, the new that will be inside of your friends, the new that will be inside of you. That's what God wants us to do. In Ephesians 5 and 8, it says, "For once you were full of darkness, but now you have light from the Lord. So live as people of light." That's what he wants us to do, to live as people of light, not people who are down and out, not people who are whose language is tearing people down instead of building people up, not people whose attitudes are nasty or conceited or prideful or arrogant or ignorant or childish. He wants us to be like him. And none of those words that I just said describe the character of Jesus Christ or his Father. We are to serve people. We are to love. We are to be peacemakers. We are to be people who use godly wisdom to choose to love people, even when it's difficult. We are people who are to not focus on what we see, to not focus our thoughts and concentrate our thoughts on what we see on this earth, but to concentrate our thoughts and think of thoughts that are of God, so he can keep us in perfect peace. We are to be people who are to be strong, rooted in Christ. Those who are bold and courageous, not ashamed, immovable, despite what we experience, despite what we see, despite what our family members experience, despite what they go through, we are to be the light. We are to be those who challenge the world, to challenge what the culture says, to challenge what the enemy is doing. And because we all know that it's spiritual. Again, we do not wrestle against flesh and blood, but we wrestle against power, principalities, rulers of darkness, spiritual wicked hosts in high places. We are to be the children of the light, the people of the light, shining for all to see, so that we can attract others and lead them into the way that they should go, because he says he is the way, the truth, and the life. And we want to embody that. We want to conform to that. Not what the world wants us to be, not what mom and daddy, sister, brother, cousin, auntie, uncle, whatever friends want us to be. We are to be who God created us to be, and be happy about it, be joyful about it, be confident in it, and go after it and pursue it with boldness, with bravery, knowing and waiting and trusting that it's all gonna work out. And when we seek God and we seek his righteousness and we follow after him and we walk in obedience and we walk by faith and not by sight, he will continue to just blow our mind and allow us to just blossom and just glow and just be the people of light, be the people who others can see, like, wow, she's really changed, or wow, God is doing a new thing. I want to know that God too. I want to know who Jesus is too. regardless of what they may have said or done in the past, you can't allow that to stop you. Just like Moana, just like me. I have every reason to be upset. I have every reason to be sad. I have every reason to be bitter. But what is that going to do? How is that going to help to change the world? How is that going to help change the lives of, or be an example to the little ones in my family, or the teenagers in my family that's coming up, or even older people in my family that's coming up? My friends, how is me being bitter going to change the world? I've been shot. I've had breast cancer. I've had surgery after surgery. I've lost my breast. I've lost my hair. I've lost family members back to back to back to back. I've lost friends who I thought would be in my life forever. I've had people betray me. I have had people just do me dirty and use me. People who just ghost me. But guess what? It was still all a part of God's plan. And it was all needed and necessary for me to be able to be grateful for the things I have now, to learn those lessons, and to be a testimony to people coming up after me, strangers or family or friends and loved ones that, or, you know, like I said, strangers that I don't even know, to share how I got through it, how I made it over. And I wouldn't be able to do that if it wasn't for the lights around me, the encouragement that I've had. And for the light that God has already placed inside of me, but I didn't know it at first. But when I rededicated my life, almost literally this month, it will be a whole year of me rededicating my life to Christ. The light that I thought was gone, the light that I thought was gone a long time ago, He restored it. And now I'm shining and I'm living in it and I'm grateful for it. And that's what I want for you all to do. My name is Audrey. Noble strength. People look up to me. People admire the strength that I have. People admire my ability to withstand great pressure. And that's it just blew my mind how that's what my name means. And that's literally what I've been going through. That's who I am. I'm strong. I'm courageous, I'm brave. Even though sometimes I don't feel like it, I got it in me to do it. There's nothing that I can't do. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. You can do all things through Christ who strengthens you. What does your name mean? Do you know who you are? Who you really are? Do you know what you can do? Do you know what God has placed inside of you? And if you don't know your purpose, I say that you seek God, and your purpose is to glorify Him with your life. That's one. But there's something specific that He wants you to do in this earth. So I pray that you will continue that you will either continue to pursue it and seek God in it, or that you will start today to ask God, Lord, what is it that you want me to do? What is it that you have for me in this earth to do? And trust and be patient in Him showing you it. Because when He shows it to you, He's already giving you the ability to carry it out. Just like Moana, every day, as a child, she would be running to that water. The water would even bring her little gifts. The water would help carry her through her journey. It took care of her. Yes, it was a movie, but like a Disney movie, but like I said, it had so many different themes that was just touching my heart. So it made me want to get on here and just remind y'all of who, and to ask, to remind you of your name, to remind you of the power that is in your name, to remind you of in the power that lives inside of you, and to remind you of the light that's inside of you, and to be that light. Because God says we are a chosen people. We are royal priests of holy nations. We are God's very own possession. As a result, we can show others the goodness of God, for He called us out of darkness into His wonderful light. We are royal. You know who you are. Like she said, they may have stolen the heart from inside you. They may have told you what you can and cannot do. They may have not supported you. They may not have loved you the right way. They may not have treated you the right way. They may not believe that you can do it. But you know who you are. That what you experience, what they say, what they don't say, what they do, what they don't do, does not define you. My experiences being shot, having cancer, being molested and raped as a child, being afraid all the time of change, being fearful of making decisions, thinking that I'm not hearing God right, being stuck and feeling stuck. All of those things do not define me. Those things are chapters in my life that I needed, even though I didn't like it and didn't want to go through it and didn't understand it, but I know that I needed it to get to where I am today, to build me up and to be able to be that light, to be able to bring someone else into the light, to be able to lead somebody else to Christ. Those things do not define you. I now know who I am. And it's not just power in my name, y'all. There is power in the name of Jesus. Power that there's power in his name. There's peace in his name. There's joy in his name. There's love in his name. There's wisdom in his name. There's hope and there's faith in his name. There is power in Jesus' name. Jesus says, you can ask for anything in my name and I will do it so that the Son can bring glory to the Father. And what does that mean? That means whatever we ask that aligns with God's will and leads us to salvation, which is deliverance from sin and its consequences by faith in Jesus Christ, and asking things that will glorify him. Whatever you ask in Jesus' name that will glorify him, that aligns with his will, that will lead us to salvation, he will bring it to pass in your life. There's power in his name. Whenever I go through anything, whenever I feel frustrated, whenever I don't understand something, whenever people are getting on my last nerve, whenever there are things that come up that try to distract me, try to like get me to react or respond in a different type of way, things that won't, like things that try to, you know, bring out that ugh and that wrath and that anger inside of me, I call on his name and I promise you it makes me feel so much better. I can't even put a number on it. Not 1,000, not 1,000,000. I can't even put a number on the power that I feel, like Kirk Franklin and Rance Allen say, the power that they feel when they call his name, it is so real. It is so real. It is so real. He's the way, he's the truth, he's the life. He said that. And it's so real. He is the way that I'm able to not respond and react negatively. He's the way. He's the truth his truth has changed me. It's freed me. It's delivered me. It's reminded me of who I am. It's reminded me that those circumstances and experiences and situations in my life have not always been favorable. He's still good. It's all because of the power in his name. The power that comes with calling on Jesus' names is like no other. And in an instant, demons have to flee. In an instant, the devil has to flee. In an instant, things can change when you call on the name of the Lord. So remember that he knows your name. He knows what we need even before we know we need it. And he will get us through it to the promise. Remember not to dim your light ever, 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 ever. not for anybody. If God has placed something in you, go after it and do it, because it's placed there for a reason. And he's going to make sure you get to it and that you serve out your purpose in this earth to fix that problem. Hold your head up, because we know who we are, and we are royalty, y'all. Despite what we see, despite what we hear, despite what we experience, despite what even our loved ones experience and see and hear, trust that God's got it, because according to his word, nothing shall be impossible for him. Do you know who you are? Who you really are? Do you know your name? What does your name mean? What does your name mean? And if you look it up and you can't find nothing, that's all right. Because I've already told you who you are. You're royal. You are a child of the light. So remember that. Don't ever forget that. Don't ever dim it for anybody. Don't let nobody block your praise. Don't let nobody block your passion or your dreams. Go for it. I know I am. So God, right now, I thank you, Lord. I thank you for our names. I thank you for our names truly defining who we are, truly defining our personality. I thank you, Lord, for your power, the power that is in your son's name, for the power that lies inside of all of us, given to us through the Holy Spirit, the power and the authority. I thank you, God, for the peace that surpasses all understanding right now in this very moment. I thank you, God, for being able to speak to us through animated movies, to be able to know that even though it's a movie, even though it's a cartoon, Lord, we can apply some of those lessons to our real life, and we can align it with scripture, and it will encourage somebody. And I pray, Lord Jesus, that you will just continue to allow our lights to shine in this earth. I thank you, God, that death will respect our purpose. I thank you, God, that we have breath in our bodies right now. So that means that we still have time and we still have a purpose in this earth. And I pray, Lord Jesus, that my friends and my family seek out your kingdom and your righteousness, and to conform to your character, to spend time with you and make room for you so they too can know and see the light that they have inside of them, Lord. Despite what they experienced, despite what they are going through right now on today, despite what people may have said about them or to them to try to knock them down, to try to block them, to try to tell them that they can't change or that they will never change, help them to see and remember who they are in you. To not allow darkness to rule their minds and rule their hearts. I pray right now for just a supernatural intervention for every single person watching this video, Lord. I thank you, God, that their life will be new, that their minds will be renewed and transformed through your word. I pray, Lord Jesus, that you will help me and those around me to be lights in this earth. To let our light shine. To not be afraid of it, to not be afraid of what people will say or what people will think, but that we will walk with victory, we will walk with boldness, we will walk and be courageous and trust, God, that you've given us all that we need to live godly lives. I thank you that you have given us all that we need to live godly lives, God. And I thank you, Lord, that you will continue to call our names and that you will continue to touch our hearts and be right there with us, Lord. In all that we, in our day-to-day lives, in all that we experience, Thank you, Lord, that nothing that we have done or nothing that we may do will ever separate us from you, and that you love us no matter what. And I pray and I thank you, God, for grace. And I pray, God, that we don't use your grace as an excuse to sin, but we use your grace as a reason to turn away from sin, to humble ourselves before you, Lord, and live righteously. It's not boring. It's not too hard. It's what you created all of us to do in the first place, Lord. So I pray, God, for just understanding, more understanding, obedience, Lord, and strength to just endure one day at a time. I thank you, God, for changing me. I thank you, Lord, for all the things that I had to experience, even though I didn't like them all. But I thank you, God, that you brought me through, that I don't look like what I've been through. I thank you, God, for the new that is happening right now in Jesus' name. And God, I pray that whoever watches this video, whoever watches any of my videos or whatever content that I put up, God, is blessed and encouraged to keep going. I thank you, Holy Spirit, for speaking through me right now. And I thank you, God, for all that you have done, all that you are doing right now, and all that you will do. No matter what, God, I trust you and I thank you, Jesus. I thank you for saving me, and I pray, Lord, to continue to let my light shine in this earth and in my family and with those of my friends. And I pray, Lord, that you will allow them, Lord, to let their light shine. I pray, God, that they will not dim it, that they will not walk away from you in hard times, but they will trust that they too can experience your love and your joy and your peace and live kingdom and not the way of the world. God, I thank you on today. And I thank you, Lord, for being so good. In Jesus' name, amen. I love y'all. Peace. Thanks for watching. And if y'all did look up your names and what they meant, leave it in the comments. Love y'all. Peace.